Now, back when I were a lad, before we had the face tube and the U-book, we had to be entertained by simpler pleasures, one of which was a puzzle called Spot the Difference, where you'd have two separate images that looked very similar but had some small alterations to them. Let's recreate the magic of those times by trying to find the differences between these two consumer units from Lewden. Now, as you can see, they're the same on the front, and they're the same on the sides, but what's this? On the top here, we've got different shape knockouts, and on the back of here, there's also a quirky little grommet, as you can see in this still image. Now, there's one more difference as well, but that's hiding under the lid here, so stay tuned to the end of the video to see what that is, along with some hidden gems from the Second Amendment to the 18th edition of BS7671. But what's going on with these round knockouts? For a long time, Lewden have been advocates of the square knockout, so why the change, and are these round holes going to be round our way permanently? Well, the good news is that both variants of consumer units from Lewden are going to be available side by side, so you can pick whichever type you prefer, which is great because actually they both have advantages and proper applications. Let's start with the classic square knockout. What's the benefit here? Well, obviously it's ideal if you're running cables in trunking. The big knockout there is 40mm by 40mm, so if you're running 50 by 50 trunking down the wall, that's pretty much spot on. And the smaller knockout to the left there is about 32mm by 18mm, so perhaps a 40 by 25mm trunking would be suitable for that one. Now, if you're not using trunking, but you still want to bring your cables through the top or the bottom of the board, then you can use Lewden's rectangular grommets with their unique pierceable skin to maintain IP ratings when you bring the cables through there. Another advantage to using the square holes is that it actually gives you a much larger area for bringing cables through than a round hole of the same diameter would. So this 40 by 40 mil hole will give you a hole of 1600 square millimeters, whereas a round hole of the same diameter would only be 1256 square mil. So it's a more efficient use of the space there. So if square knockouts are so good, why have Lewden included round ones as well as square ones and only round ones on this board? Well, it's so you have options and flexibility. For example, sticking with our original board here, the 32mm diameter round holes have been strategically placed to make it easy to bring tails through to the main switch, no matter which face of the board you bring them through. Looking at the board with only round holes now, there's still some very clever thought gone into these that you may not be aware of. So, for example, we've still got the 32mm options for bringing tails through on all faces, but there's additional options top and bottom for final circuit entry. At the end of the row of knockouts, there's a 25mm diameter hole for larger cables, but then between the 32mm and the 25mm hole, there's a row of 20mm diameter holes for smaller cables to gain access, which is all good. However, what about if you want to bring several larger cables through there and the 20mm diameter holes simply aren't big enough? Of course, you can always drill them out to be larger with a hole saw or a cone cutter, but even with this simple process, Lewden have put some thought into this by carefully spacing the holes to allow them all to be opened up to 25mm without compromising each other. Little touches that could make all the difference to your installation, and they're done so well, you probably wouldn't even be aware of them. Of course, having the option to have all round holes has its advantages as well, because it means you can bring cables through grommets, glands, conduit, or steel wire armoured. So by creating the two variants of consumer unit, it means you can pick the correct type of knockout for the individual installation that you're putting it into. Now, just when you thought we were done with knockouts, we're going to look at the back of the unit, and here we've got the option to knock out a rectangular blank and install this special grommet that fills that in, which then gives us further options for removing the plastic blank. So we can have half the blank open for cable access on the left or the right, or we can take the whole thing out if we've got lots of cables coming in at the back. And that plastic grommet prevents the sheath of the cable from getting damaged where it passes through the metalwork. Now, I promised you at the start of the video that there was a surprise hiding under the lids of the unit, and it's now time to have a look at that. So if we look closely, you can see here that we've got pretty much all the protective devices in one unit. And it's actually quite a nice representation of some of the changes that we've seen in the Second Amendment to the 18th edition of BS7671. You can see here we've got an MCB protecting the surge protection device, so there's no more risk assessment needed for that under the Second Amendment, and hopefully we'll be seeing a lot less resistance to that being installed now. There's certain places that it must be installed, and away from these, the only reason it wouldn't be installed is if the owner of an installation declares that it is not required due to any loss or damage being tolerable, and they accept the risk of damage to equipment and any consequential loss. Then we've got an RCBO, and looking very closely at that, you'll see it's a type A RCBO, which makes sense, as under the new amendment, type AC RCDs can only be used to serve fixed equipment where it's known that the load current contains no DC components. So that's, you know, basically nowhere. And then finally, it's Lewden's new AFDD, all ready for use in compliance with the second amendment, the 18th edition of BS7671 in the relevant places. We're on the verge of releasing a free training package on AFDDs in the second amendment to help you with your CPD, so please keep an eye on the know-how page of eFIXX.co.uk for that, or the Lewden Academy page on lewden.com. Depending on when you're watching this, there may even be a link in the description below. But at this point, it's worth noting that Lewden's AFDDs have been independently laboratory tested and certified by Intertek and bears the European Safety S mark. The S mark is a voluntary certification scheme demonstrating that the product continually meets all relevant technical safety requirements verified by regular inspections of the manufacturing facility by Intertek. So that's some added reassurance that you're getting the top quality products that we've come to expect from Lewden. So there we go, that's a quick overview of some of the changes to these consumer units from Lewden. But as always, we want to hear from you. Which type of knockout do you prefer and why? Are you looking forward to installing AFDDs? What do you think to the Second Amendment in general? Whatever your thoughts or questions, please leave those in the comments section below. And as always, thank you very much for watching.